Hello, I'm Carly McAvoy. Today I'm talking about slope of a line. I'm talking about the formula that you can use to find slope. So we looked in the last video at some examples where we counted from one point to the other and we found the rise and the run. The rise is a shorthand way of saying vertical change, and the run is a shorthand way of saying horizontal change. But we're always looking for the change in the y and the change in the x. We use M for an abbreviation for slope. So if we look at this particular two points, if you want to look at the rise, we're going to go 1, 2, 3 down. That's negative 3. And the run, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 5 over. So I can see from the picture that my slope would be negative 3 fifths, down 3 and over 5. Okay, that's hard to read. But what if I don't always want to draw a picture? What if I was just given these two points and I wanted to use a formula? Well, when you're going from 2 down to negative 1, you're actually saying what's the change or the difference between the y's. A difference is a subtraction problem. And when you're going from negative 3 over to 2, you're saying what's the difference between negative 3 and 2? And again, that's a difference between the x values. And so we have a subtraction problem where we subtract the y's on the top and the x's on the bottom. I'm going to rewrite these two points, negative 3, 2, and 2, negative 1. You'll agree that we have an x and a y, and again another x and a y. Since we have two x's and two y's, we give them subscripts, which is what we see in this formula. That is, the first x, I'm going to say, is subscripted as 1. And then the first y is subscripted as 1. But the second point, because I have a new x, I'm going to say that's x with a designation of a subscript 2. And this one has a designation of a subscript 2 for the y. Now I can see where those numbers come from. It doesn't mean squared or anything like that. It's just a subscript to identify two different x's and two different y's. So if I want to use this formula, I just plug in. My y sub 2 was negative 1. So I put in the negative 1. It's a subtraction, so I put that in. My y sub 1, well, that was 2. And then I go and I say my x sub 2 was 2 minus, because that's in the formula, my x sub 1, which is negative 3. Notice that I'm subtracting a negative 3. I don't just put minus 3. I know it's basic, but remember, that's a really common mistake for people to plug in the negative incorrectly. What happens here? Negative 1 minus 2, that's negative 3, and 2 minus a negative 3 is 2 plus 3, or 5. So slope is negative 3 fifths. That's what we saw by counting the difference, but we can also find the difference by using subtraction. So it's a way to find the slope without having to draw and count. So the four examples I have are just using that formula to find the slope of a line given two points. All right, so I have, I'm just going to always label these as 1 and 2 the way they're shown, but it doesn't matter which point you decide to be the first point and which point you decide to be the second point, you'd get the same answer. What I want to do is figure out what my y sub 2 is. Well, y sub 2 is negative 1 minus y sub 1, which is 1. x sub 2 is 3, and x sub 1 is negative 2. There always has to be, you always have to be thinking about those negatives. So what I get, negative 1 minus 1 is negative 2, and 3 plus 2 is 5. So I have a slope of negative 2 fifths. If I was to picture that on the number line, it would be falling. It's pretty close to this one, negative, but I know it's a negative slope, so it would go down from left to right. Okay, the next one, my y sub 2 on top, let me label these. If you label them, sometimes you make fewer mistakes as you plug in. Y sub 2 is negative 2. Minus y sub 1, which is also negative 2. And then x sub 2 is 3 minus x sub 1, which is 5. Negative 2, this is minus a minus, which is actually plus. Negative 2 plus 2 is 0. And then I have negative 2 on the bottom. But whenever I have 0 divided by anything, that gives me 0. So this has a slope of 0. If I was to look at this on the number line or on the coordinate system, I would see a horizontal line. That's what we get when we get slope of 0 is a horizontal line. We saw that in the last video. Okay, what about this one? Well, I want to do y sub 2. I want to just make sure I can see the formula up there. Y sub 2 minus y sub 1. X sub 1, y sub 1, x sub 2, y sub 2. Y sub 2 is 3 minus negative 2. Negative 1 for x sub 2 minus 4. When I simplify that, I have 3 plus 2, which is 5. And negative 1 minus 4, which is negative 5. But if I have negative 5 over 5, that's going to simplify to just negative 1. I always want to simplify my fraction to lowest terms. In this case, I get negative 1. In the last one, y sub 2, let me label them. Y sub 2 is 4. Y sub 1 is negative 1. There's a minus sign in between. X sub 2 is 4 minus 4. That's 4 plus 1, which is 5, and 4 minus 4, which is 0. That's different than what happened up here. Here, our numerator was 0, which gives us 0. Here, our denominator is 0. So this slope is undefined. Sometimes you'll hear it said there is no slope. All right? So, one thing I want to mention about 0 is you shouldn't put a slash through it. A slash through it means more like undefined than with 0 when you're doing math. So be careful not to be slashing your zeros. I know some of you are told to do that on your job or something, but it's not good in math. It means something different. All right, I will see you next time. Have a